let's start with what do we call as conventional project management. Because unless we don't appreciate that thing, right, there's no merit in appreciating what follows up next. And by the way, as we move forward, agile project management is just another common sense of doing things. Let's appreciate that. It's not a silver bullet. It's not a panacea. It's not a cure for the failing projects. It's not a miracle. Okay. And just like any baby who steps foot in the world loves new things, we are all babies in the agile world. Okay. So you'll have to give us some time to nurture ourselves. We'll grow. In the process, we'll probably be able to delight our quality. That's the way we'll be able to do it. Okay. So again, not too much focus on the diagram. I think it's not readable. But then, it's very well known what we mean by conventional project management. It's essentially a very structured ambience where you operate, right? Not very realistic, you know, in terms of what you might actually expect. But let's assume that the environment is structured enough. That is, you can realistically plan things meticulously, one after another. A chained way of doing things. Chain does not mean it's a serial progression one after another. Chain means that you can go, you can come back, you can go, you can come back, but still things are connected, right? So the structured environment, in fact, you know, the PM Bok being there, the prince, right? Can anyone recall the full form of PIMS?
Projects in controlled environment.
Controlled environment, right? So no IT person, you know, coined the term. It's been there since quite a few decades. You know, that merit is up there, right? You need a controlled and structured environment. And the changes in general are very expensive. It goes on exponentially becoming expensive as you close on towards the delivery of the project. Aligns very well, you know, with the construction world, so-called, right? Infrastructure. You cannot say that 80% of my bridge is being built, right? And now I have a problem with the pedestrian. So let's, you know, do something wrong out here, let's make a cut and do that. You can sometimes, but assume it's not always possible. You should have rather planned that thing earlier. Why wake up now? Right? And the entire gamut of such principles falls under different terminological names. You can call it a waterfall model, a typical cascading waterfall, you know, rolls across slopes and goes down and reaches from the initiation point to the termination point. Right? That's what the goal, and it gradually goes one step further. Right? You can call it stage gate model as well. Right? Different people have different terminals. Essentially, it's the same thing. And now, the PM Bok, the PMIs, the US organizations' way of viewing the thing, which is now the more global thing, or the Prince 2's way of looking into the thing, or IPMA's way of looking into the things, all of these broadly cater to the waterfall kind of model. Broadly because there are appendices to that thing to make sure how can we further extend that thing. There are extensions of the same thing, but essentially all of them are sequential in nature. You see where I get here, right? And I'm not going to the diagram, but goes through the typical five stages. You have a requirement analysis phase, then you have a design phase, right? You go to the implementation, verify or validate, and post delivery, you go to the maintenance phase. Those are the broad five blocks. With a slight deviation from this model, what we have is popularly called the sashimi model, right? Here the things are not necessarily as sequential as you want them to be. For example, and again I'm trying to deliberately keep myself away from the IT world, although I myself belong to that, but let's appreciate it from the construction, infrastructure, where I don't have much experience, but I'm trying to apply it, right? You need not finish each and every stage of your design to start implementation in starting phases. Imagine the entire Metro Railway project. Obviously, there was a rigorous planning, you know, cycle, approval, other things going on. At the same time, there were pockets of the railway lines which were not even thought of or designed. It may be in the broad horizon. Even now, new railway lines are getting constructed, right? You're thinking of extending it all the way until Greater Noida, right? So those things necessarily were not planned meticulously. They were maybe thought of. But you had started implementation design of what you needed, right? So design, implementation, validation, all those things need not be strictly sequential. There can be some overlapping phases. In fact, stage gate model also is flexible enough to allow that overlap. So this is not in contradiction to the waterfall model, by the way. It's a logical extension, right? So where are we right now? We understand whatever we are doing in the conventional project, you know, management, whether it's in the IT world or non-IT world, we can understand this thing. Without knowing the terminologies, we are doing that thing anyway, right? Let's move one stage ahead. And I like you to appreciate the cartoon. I do not know whether it's visible towards the end. Is it?
Yes.
So let's just go through it. How many of you like Dilbert's cartoon? Say that today is for those who cannot see from the back. So today is the third anniversary of our first meeting to discuss project requirements. And we are still discussing requirements. Does anybody else have a problem? Say, shut up. When you are done, can we talk about requirements? So for 3 years, planning going on. I'm not saying it's not required. A typical Boeing project, you know, what I've heard, because I was directly associated with them at a research stage. They have a meticulous planning stage where planning and execution carry on for a decade. You cannot say planning is done, the aircraft will be rolled out in this way, and now just go and manufacture. Every stage there's redundancy planning, there's an optimization planning going on. So those things are there. But what we hear from there is that there's an impatient world. Okay? There's an impatient set of customers who think that if they lose the window of opportunity, it's already too late for them to achieve what they want. So what's the goal of this project, which completes everything as per the plan, but the plan does not deliver what the customer want, right? So it's not only about cost and control and quality. It's the time is another dimension which is very important. Now, the logical fallacious state that I can lead into is by saying that I am trying to invent something or trying to describe something which will make things faster. No, I'm not. So conventional project management, we talked about, and we'll transition to Agile PM. It's not about being fast. It's not about being able to meet the requirements and the project delivery faster in a more efficient way. It's a very, very popular misconception. Let's get out of it now, even before we define Agile PM. So just before we started, there was this natural discussion that took place about Agile PM and how can we reduce the cycle time of a project, you know, by using Agile PM. The connotation of the word Agile, you know, is actually wrong in this context. The natural meaning of Agile being nimbleness gives you a sense of feeling that because you are agile and active, you'll probably run quickly and you will eat the end goal quickly. Well, let's look at it from a different perspective. A micro or a protozoa, right, always moves, spreads its tentacles, right, always very active if given a proper environment. Doesn't necessarily mean that if it moves chaotically, it will reach from one point to other point faster.